Hello everyone. Today we are going to start the lecture number 3 of ECA subject. Okay, so the topic of lecture number 3, which is we are going to discuss the effect of coupling capacitor and bypass capacitor on frequency response of amplifier, and we will discuss the gain bandwidth product of a amplifier. So we have drawn one amplifier circuit with the voltage divider biasing. We have connected R1, R2 and RC, RE resistor. We have connected CC1 is a coupling capacitor, CB is the bypass capacitor, which is connected here across the RE resistor. So these two are the coupling capacitor and this one is called the bypass capacitor. Okay, now let us first discuss the effect or the behavior of capacitor for the DC voltage or signal and with the AC signal, that how the capacitor will act for DC signal and it will act for AC signal. We are knowing that the frequency of DC signal is zero and the reactance or the resistance, we can say reactance is the preferable name for the capacitor. It is one type of resistance which is change with the frequency. The equation of reactance for the capacitor is 1/2πfc, where we put f is equal to 0, so we will get 1/0, which is nothing but the infinite. So xc, the reactance purchased by capacitor, is infinite. So act, we can say that infinite resistance is nothing but the open circuit. Okay, so capacitor in DC behaves like a open circuit. Okay, now for the AC signal. Okay, so for the AC signal, frequency is not equal to zero. So xc is equal to 1/2πfc, so value of capacitor is comparatively large and the frequency f is also variable. So we will get the approximately 1/large value, so it is nothing but the near about 0. So the value of xc, the reactance of capacitor, is near about 0 for AC signal. So we can say that if reactance is 0, then it is act as a short circuit. Okay, so for AC signal, when we are applying to the amplifier, then it is acting as a short circuit for AC. Okay, now when we discuss about the transistor, then this amplifier, then this amplifier contains this VCC voltage, which is nothing but the supply voltage for this amplifier and which will providing the biasing to the transistor. And why we are applying the biasing to the transistor? So simply to put transistor into active region. Okay, and whenever our transistor is in active region, then and then it can amplify our signal. Okay, so this DC voltage is required and it is must. So this portion is called the DC portion. Okay, it is this four resistor and transistor is only a voltage divider biasing we have applied to the transistor. When we are going to analyze the DC circuit or DC portion, then we don't have to consider this part and this part. Okay, so only this circuit. So this circuit we have already studied in the chapter number 2, the transistor biasing. Okay, sorry, chapter number 3. So now let us discuss in detail what is the use of this coupling capacitor CC1 and CC2 in the transistor amplifier circuit. Okay, so once when we are applying a signal which is to be amplified by this amplifier, we connect one coupling capacitor in series with the source. So what it will do? So it will filter out the DC part in this source. If there is any DC portion inside the signal source, then it will filter out and it will not enter into this particular amplifier stage. So if this DC will enter in this stage, then it will affect the biasing of the transistor and the Q point of this particular amplifier will change. So we will not get the faithful amplification if the DC will affect to this VCC and this biasing portion or the circuit. Okay, at the output side we have connected the coupling capacitor too. So this is a coupling capacitor we have connected. So we just required a AC output, which is amplified signal of the input signal which we have applied. So to get only the AC output signal, amplified signal, we have connected here CC2 capacitor. So this capacitor will particularly block the DC current which is entering at the output side. Okay, so the transistor amplifier which having a two types of responses, one is simply a AC response and second one is the DC response. So this will summation of both responses will be the total response of this transistor amplifier. DC response we are getting is due to the biasing circuit. So without signal there is some IB current, DC IB, and the IB current, when the IB current will flow, the IC current will flow, which is nothing but the beta times IB. Okay, so the IB will flow, IC will flow, IC will flow, then IE will flow. So there is some DC current which is already flowing and which is to provide the transistor into active region. Okay, so DC voltage we required, it is by default requirement to turn, keep the transistor amplifier on. And when we apply the AC signal, so the AC signal will also get mixed up with the DC response. So we will get the overall response which is AC plus DC. Okay, now let us discuss that CC1 and CC2 is called the coupling capacitor. Why it is called the coupling capacitor? So we know that we don't want to couple a DC portion from this side to enter into this side. So it is a one type of coupling which will isolate the DC part. Again here it is another type of coupling which will not allow to enter the DC current to output portion. Okay, so that's why its name is called the coupling capacitor. Okay, so this two line whatever I have explained, which is written here, that it contains source of a signal with amplifier without affecting DC biasing of the amplifier. Second, that is, it couples the multiple stages of amplifier with a DC isolation. That means one amplifier is not sufficient and we want to connect another stage of amplifier just in a cascade format, that one after another, then we have to connect another stage in such a way here that the only the AC portion will go to the input of the second stage. Okay, so to provide such type of things we are also requiring the coupling capacitor. So the output of the first stage and also the only the AC portion will go to the input of the another amplifier. Okay, so this was about the coupling capacitor. Now let us discuss what is bypass capacitor. Okay, so this one is the our bypass capacitor CB. Okay, now let us discuss first thing, that effect of resistor RE in amplifier. As we have studied in chapter number 3 transistor biasing, that what is the need of this RE resistor, right? So the RE resistor is called the one type of feedback resistor. And why this resistor we required in this amplifier? So we are knowing that the due to the temperature, if collector current will rise, it will use to stabilize this collector current which is increased by the temperature or the leakage current. Okay, so to stable out the Q point we required the RE resistor. RE is one type of voltage feedback resistor and this will decreases the IB current value, and hence this stabilizes the IC current. So this all theory that how feedback mechanism works, how RA will decreases the gain, how the collector current is stabilized, how the Q point will become stable, this all these things we have already studied into the chapter number 3. Okay, now the problem is that here the two types of responses are mixed out at the input. So it is one is the base current, which is due to the DC voltage we have applied, and another is the base current, which is flowing due to the signal. Okay, so now here whenever the collector current or the IE current will flow, which will reaches to here at the emitter, so we have a two type of current at this point. That means we have a DC current and we have a AC current. Now if we allow DC current or AC current both from the RE register, if the bypass capacitor is does not exist, then what will happen? This signal current which is flowing from the base, and due to base current the IC current will vary. So this will also affect, this will also creates the voltage drop across the RE, and it will also stabilized. So these things we does not required. So we just required that the DC current, whatever is going to flow, that is only stabilized by RE. Okay, so we don't required that AC current will flow from the RE register. Okay, so we have put one capacitor parallel to the RE. So what will happen if the DC current is there? It will not allow to go from the capacitor, as we are knowing that for the DC we have a capacitor act as a open circuit. So DC just have a one way to flow from the RE register. Okay, so it is flowing through flowing due to the biasing, and when we apply the signal, the AC current will flow, and as for AC current, this capacitor will provide the zero, near about zero reactance, so it will choose the low resistance path, and whole AC current will pass through this capacitor. So it will not affect, or it will not create a voltage drop across the RE register. Okay, so basically RE is reducing the gain. Okay, but it is only for DC. But when we apply the AC signal due to bypass capacitor, the gain will increase. Okay, so the effect of RE will be nullified for AC due to this bypass capacitor, as we require to increase the gain of the amplifier. Okay, so this is the need of the bypass capacitor. So we have seen that due to RE we are getting the decrease in gain. Why? That we have understood, or that we have studied right now. So also we have discussed that RE is the feedback resistor, provides the negative feedback. Okay, and we are knowing that negative feedback will decreases the gain. That is the universal rule of any amplifier, that when we apply the negative feedback, it will reduces the gain. And as also we have discussed that the total response is nothing but the DC response plus AC response. So DC response we are getting only due to biasing, and biasing is necessary for amplifier to keep our transistor into active region. Okay, and the AC response is nothing but the our actual amplified signal, or amplification of signal. This AC response is nothing but the actual signal which we are going to apply, and we are getting the output. Okay, why CB is called the bypass capacitor? So I think this answer we are also covered. It will bypasses the AC current through this path, that's why it is a bypass capacitor, name is like this. Okay, so I think whole thing is clear about the coupling capacitor and bypass capacitor. Okay, so we require for two purposes the coupling capacitor. One is to connect the source, and if there is any DC portion in the source, it will not enter into the amplifier. And second, to take the output and only AC and block the DC. Also, if we have a second stage to connect in a cascade, second amplifier, then also the capacitor is required to isolate the DC portion of this circuit and the next circuit. Okay, so the DC voltage won't interfere to both the stage. So this capacitor will isolate the DC part. Okay, now let us discuss the second topic, that is gain bandwidth product. As we have seen that the frequency response graph, which is nothing but the bandwidth or the frequency, this is the frequency, sorry, versus gain graph. Okay, so as this graph indicates that every particular amplifier having a frequency response and which is like this means that it will amplify a specific range of frequencies by this amplifier. Okay, so if we see that the gain and the frequency, means difference of frequency, if we take the higher cutoff and lower cutoff, then we will get the bandwidth. So bandwidth is nothing but the FH minus FL. Okay, so we will get the region. This is nothing but the bandwidth. Okay, now what is the relation of bandwidth with respect to gain? So we will see that gain into bandwidth of any amplifier is nothing but the constant. So why it is constant? Because gain and bandwidth both are the constant, so it is a product of two constant. So obviously both are the constant, so we will get also the product of both is constant. If we increase the gain to make this term constant, bandwidth will decrease. So as we are knowing, bandwidth will increase, sorry, gain will increase, then bandwidth will decrease to compensate this constant value. So in amplifier we have to make the trade-off of gain and bandwidth. Okay, so always remember, for transistor amplifier or further semester you will study operational amplifier, so at that time the gain into bandwidth product is equal to constant. Okay, so it is a product of two constant. So obviously one will increase, second must have to decrease, so to maintain the constant value of the product. So if we are increases the gain, see the second response, if we are increases the gain in the y axis, then the bandwidth will narrow down. Okay, bandwidth will reduce, so the bandwidth of this response is this much only, or this portion. In the first case the bandwidth is up to this much. Okay, so we can see that in the first case the bandwidth is more and gain is less. If we have increased the gain, so bandwidth will decrease and gain will increase. Okay, so as per the requirement of the gain and the bandwidth of the transistor, we can set both the constant value in the during the designing part of the amplifier. We have to fulfill the both criteria, gain requirement and bandwidth requirement. So accordingly we have to do the trade-off between both the things, and we have to design the amplifier. Okay, now second thing we have to discuss, that due to the parasitic capacitance we are getting this limited response. okay, when we are fabricating a transistor, okay, so this transistor having a two junction, base emitter and collector base junction, so it will create some parasitic capacitance across the junction. So again, as we are knowing that the effect of capacitor for AC and DC is different, okay, so here some frequencies it will allow to easily pass, some frequency they are blocking, okay. So this parasitic capacitance will affect mostly at the higher frequencies, okay. So also in the bandwidth, it is limited bandwidth, and this limitation is due to the parasitic capacitance also, okay. And this coupling capacitor and bypass capacitor will also puts their role to limit the bandwidth of a transistor amplifier, because there is a relation of reactance, okay, with the frequency. So it will specifically we can say that it will frequency specific resistance, and when we apply a different frequency or different value of the frequency, then there is a different resistance or reactance offered by the capacitor. So it will affect the response on the bandwidth, or we can say the transistor response and a specified or specific bandwidth of the transistor amplifier, okay. So now today, as a part of lecture number 3, we have concluded the two topics, effect of coupling and bypass capacitor on frequency response and gain bandwidth product. Okay, you have to remember that gain and bandwidth product is always a constant. So if we increase a one parameter, we must get decrease in the another parameter, okay. So I hope you will understand these two topics, and if you have a question, then you can WhatsApp me about your questions. Also you can write your comments into the channel, okay. So I hope you understand. Thank you so much.